Nick, why would you think people get drawn to the familiar love? What are some of the reasons? Maybe, and you can ask.
Kuna makuzo wameiva wewe.
Haya, kuiva is one. Let me tell you, as much as you're this hot, me and Sharon would be like this. I know, yeah, we know.
No,
yeah.
By the way, kuna kuanga, think of it this way. Wale watu wameiva sana ndio wale wanakuanga kwa hizi. Utapata mtu ati sijui alikula kuzo yake amembaya amechapa.
No, but also
that is relative.
Miss Jay on evidence.
And also remember, is it consciously or is it unconsciously? Do you know there are people who and it could be a rape situation?
Oh, hiyo ni mbaya. Kama ni
rape, get, yeah, because are we because by the time you're saying it, Sharon said most people are in their young stages, right? So it's 18, 19. This could be your older cousin who is luring you. It could be someone who is near 25, 26, they've understood, they've wamenda nje wamechapa around wanajua vitu, then they come preying on a young girl, or even the other way around, it's a girl who is an adult preying on a young cousin. So this is why, as in, it should not be encouraged. Consciously, if both of you are and you agree to it, then fine.
Consensually.
But it should not be you're preying on these young girls, because that, or even a young boy, it would be very, very bad.
Now,
and you see, why I say it could happen, because you trust this person. And we've seen most people who have been raped, who have been sexually assaulted. It's someone who is familiar with you. It's someone who is closer. And you see, even it could be the time you've lost your dad or your parent or something, and you're going for comfort, and then boom, it turns to other things. So as much as you're talking about it, let us look into that detail.
Correct. We'd like to just put out a disclaimer that as Punguza, we are all about following the law. Now, talking about the law, what does the law say about dating a cousin, siring a child with a cousin, and having coitus insipidus with a cousin? Now, allow me to just read for you, you know, the section.
Read, advocate, deep,
man.
DNG
I did
at
my
this point.
Prep, man. This is show number one, man. It's Pulse Live TV, you know what I'm saying? The Sexual Offences Act defines incest as sexual relations between a man and a female relative who he knows to be his daughter, and you can list this, eh? Granddaughter, sister, mother, niece, aunt, or grandmother, and sexual relations between a woman with the corresponding male relative. So the cousin has been left out. Now, it's a gap in the law, all right? And there's even, I was reading about a precedent that, you know, somebody had been prosecuted and jailed for 10 years.
Yeah.
You read that story?
Yeah.
And then he appealed. Yeah. And then went to the lower court, magistrate's court to high court.
To high court, yeah.
Then the high court judge looked at the law and said, the word cousin is not there, and released person. You freed the person. So now the word cousin has been left out of law. So perhaps it's erroneous. I do not know. It's parliamentarians who make the law. Or perhaps it's an intentional omission, because law sometimes looks at culture. And we talked about the different cultures where marrying cousins is a day-to-day thing. The Indian culture, the Somali culture, and this is not about profiling, it's just talking about general, you know, Kenyan scenarios, okay? So if even law, adding to Bible, does not prohibit or forbid.
Well, when the Bible omits, that doesn't allow.
You see, in law, and I've talked about the precedent from the High Court, which now we're using to discuss. Mm. If something is omitted from our story, if I say, I want tea, and there's no sugar, see, that means that, of course, sugar was not to be put in the tea. You know, it's common sense. Namna gani? So sasa tuchide iko wapi kama hata, you see, like people were saying ati these guys who were trending last week, ati they should have been jailed. Nini.
Okay.
They are not reading the law.
No.
So chide iko wapi? Peter na huko kama kuzoko tayari. Na si under 18. Tunasema tu ukweli.
Have you seen, you've mentioned those people, have you seen the kind of strain it has put to those families?
Strain na kuanga financial strain.
No. I'm talking about, first of all, D&D, listen. I don't know. Family is supposed to be a place of comfort.
Kama sahi kuna strain ya KCSE, watu waliloba.
Family is supposed to be a place where you go and all of us can be able to talk to each other happily without having to look at each other like, you know.
Bora mtu amelipa dawari.
No, listen, D&G. Don't make Christmas awkward. Don't make Christmas awkward for us, please. Please, sisi tunataka tuende tukae na tukule.
The only thing that made it weird was the part where
aliruka mtoi.
Okay, that's a whole different
story.
And even just getting the baby at the first place. You know, that's what made it weird. But before that, nobody knew.
And again, we need to come to the issue of...
Nobody cared.
of responsibility. We need to be fine. Even if it doesn't happen, if it happens, own up to your things, the things that you do wrong.
As a man, as we're talking about men.
Because there's nothing as painful as rejection.
Yeah.
The minute you reject someone, be it a child, be it anything, the reverse is usually very serious.
Psychologically,
you reject me now. When you will need me, you'll talk to yourself.
Kama diamond na budake.
You will talk to yourself, Baba Nani.